So folks, you all have been asking for it, so here you go. This is the One Tigress Rock Shield Bushcraft Tent, and I've been testing this out for numerous months now. I didn't want to rush and do a preview. I want to share my thoughts from the field with you all, and I can do that. While I'm not ready to give my review for this product because more testing needs to be done, I can share my initial thoughts with you. So with that being the case, I'm going to set this up in numerous ways. I have to say, folks, this is not a product that I expected to see. This is very versatile. It's very different. And when it comes to the outdoor industry, different is uncommon because most tents, most shelters are copycats of each other, but that's not the case with the Rock Shield. This is truly different, and I think you all are going to like it. I believe this to be more of a summertime shelter than a wintertime, and I will explain why that is. And of course, if you're accustomed to being out in the snow and the cold, you will see what I mean. And with that being the case, let's go ahead and set it up, go over some stats. Let's do this. I've had so many people asking about this. Luke, when are you going to take a look at it? You're the only one I trust. Well, here I am. Today, we will take a look at it. We'll set it up real quick and do a first impressions. Next will come a test night episode where this tent will face a lot of rain. Everybody loves the test night, and that is coming up very soon. With the Rock Shield, the retail price is $160. It is available in one color, that's Coyote Brown. It features a 75D ripstop nylon, 1500 millimeter hydrostatic head rating, YKK zippers. The storage bag measures 23 inches long by 6 inches wide by 6 inches tall. It comes with four 70-75 aluminum poles, two pole caps, which I will show you in just a minute, 14 tent stakes, and 10 guy lines. It features three entrances, which can be altered, and I'll show you what that means in just a moment. And when it comes to the weight, it's just over 7 pounds at 7.2 on my scale. So folks, what you have here is just one way to set up this tent. You could set this up in numerous ways, and that's because this is very versatile. And the amount of livable space inside of this is very impressive.
So check that out. You have the two poles, tons of space underneath this. The poles stick out from the top, one at both ends.
Because the poles come up through the body and out the top, you have to take one of these and put it over the top of the pole so that the tent stays waterproof, so that water doesn't enter through that hole. So you have tie-off points here so you can guide this out on both sides. And if you were to set this up to stay the night in it, I would recommend that you do this. With this setup, you have this door here, which is zipped in. And check that out. You zip it up. You also have another door on the other side. But let's say that you want to change the setups. You can unzip that. Ah, and you have a second door with zipper. And from here, you could do numerous interesting setups. Already, you can see where I'm going with this and the sort of setup that I'm doing. But this is just one more setup. There are others that you can do. With this shelter, it's all about how creative can you be. So the Rock Shield has been set up, and this truly is a very unique tent, and it presents you with so many different options for setup. From here, you could continue to alter the shape of this any way that you need to for your camping trip. As you can see, you have the four poles, two here at the front, you have two in the back. Now with these doors here, these can actually be zipped up if you want to. There's a zipper up here on the side, which I will briefly show you. There's a zipper right here. Check that out. And you can zip this up completely. Now, at this angle, it's not possible, but you can zip it up that much and then stake this out so you could still get some good airflow. Or you can bring these in just a little bit zip it all the way up. It's up to you. You can do this in so many different ways. That is a very unique aspect to this tent. And the truth is, there's nothing else like this out on the market. Now, I've had this for quite a while, and I have begun testing this out. And I can tell you folks that this is pretty cool. It really is. The setup process for this tent does take time, and also it takes a little bit of practice. You will need to learn how to set it up properly to get the right setup for you, the intended sort of setup. But the cool thing is that there's not a right way or a wrong way to set this up, because you can angle this one side higher, one side lower. You can slope this, you can have this open or this closed or vice versa. And check this out. What you have is basically a palace. You have a palace inside of this, and you are fully protected from the elements. All the seams are taped. The quality is very, very good. Now, I've had this out in light rain, and it's done very well. No issues at all. I will do a test night episode with this tent where we get this out into some heavy rain, maybe some strong storms. We will see. But yeah, so far, I'm very impressed with this. As you can see, there is no bug net. There is no bug mesh, but you can add that element yourself. You can use a bug tent. You can use a bug net and simply string it up. That works very well. You can stake it out around you. The stakeout points. There needs to be some sort of guy line there so you can really hunker this thing down. As is, the stakes go right into the loops, and it could be a little bit better. So in the future, that is an improvement that I would add to this. But as is, you will have problems with the stakes coming out of the ground because they're connected directly to the shelter material. So with some guy lines, that will help a lot. Something to keep in mind for wintertime use is that this is very large, it's very high. So the influences of snow is going to be great upon the materials, and also wind. From any angle, this is a shelter that's going to be greatly impacted by the wind. So you have to keep that in mind. You will want to stake it out. You will want to guy it out and be prepared to make adjustments as you need to. If you decide to use this in the wintertime, snow loading is going to be somewhat poor on this because of the design. For summertime use, absolutely awesome. Again, you have to add your own bug mesh, bug protection, but that is rather easy to do. So folks, let's give you some dimensions with this setup in this form factor. You're looking at roughly 63 inches high. From the furthest edge to right here at the door, you're looking at 85 inches, which is a little bit over 7 feet. And from the widest point, this is roughly 162 inches long. Now do keep in mind, folks, that those dimensions are for this type of setup, but even if you had this zip down right here, I gave you the measurements for it. So you should have all the information that you need. Of course, if you have any questions, email me. I'll answer those for you. And also, test night, I'll do a setup video, and the review ultimately should answer all of your questions. With this tent, folks, I think it's great that it comes with the poles. Again, you get four of those. With most tents that allow you to set up in funky ways like this, you would have to use your trekking poles. But as is, you do not need them. I can see some people wanting these poles to be connected together with shock cord, but there is a reason not to do this, because if you want to, you could take a section out, right? And that lowers this substantially. So here with this door, for an example, you can take out one section and lower it just like this, so you have a nice angle for water to shed. In the future, I will have more videos on One Tigress products, because I have numerous products in testing right now, including their splicing stove. Unfortunately, I had an issue and I have to get another one from the company. The stove requires two matching size pieces for the front and back. They're taller. Then the sides are shorter. Well, I only got one long piece and three shorties, so it doesn't fit correctly. But nonetheless, that video is coming up soon. Also, I have the Outback Retreat coming up as well. So for the Rock Shield, that is it. Make sure to comment down below, share your thoughts about this tent. What do you all think about this design? This is truly unique in many ways, and yes, I am impressed. So I want to hear from you all. Are you guys impressed with this? What do you all think about it? What sort of setup do you want to do with it? Until next time, everyone, take care, strength and honor, have a good one.